Hello friends, how are you guys? I hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to discuss or see the difference between pipe and tube. So without further ado, let's get started on the video. Most of the people use the words pipe and tube interchangeably and they think that both are the same. However, there is a significant difference between the two. So at first, we need to know exactly what a pipe is and what a tube is. So in layman terms, we all know pipe is a hollow tube with round cross section for the conveyance of products like fluids, gases, pellets, powders and more, which is almost true. A pipe is a pressure tight cylinder used to transport fluids. Pipes are defined on the basis of unitless nominal pipe size NPS, nominal bore NB, nominal dia DN and thickness as scheduled. Like you can see in this picture, NPS 1.5 inches and pipe is where you can see the outer dia is fixed as 1.9 inches. Internal dia which gets changed based on thickness. Like here for schedule 40, it is 1.61 inches. For a given NPS, the outside diameter stays constant and the wall thickness increases with larger schedule number. The inside diameter will depend upon the pipe wall thickness specified by the schedule number. You must see our video on thickness calculation where we have explained briefly about NPS and schedule and how to calculate thickness with an example. Now we will quickly see what a tube is. A tube is also hollow but available in round, rectangular, squared or oval cross sections also, measured by outside diameter OD and wall thickness WT. Express the true dimensional value in inches or millimeters. You can see in here 1.5 inches tube OD is 1.5 inches, where in case of pipe, it was 1.9 inches OD. Usually, thickness of tube is specified in gauge, Birmingham wire gauge BWG and standard wire gauge SWG, which is a range from 0 to 36, but in industry, we use 7 to 24 majorly. For a given size of tube, the outside diameter stays constant, same as pipe, and the wall thickness increases with smaller gauge number. Let's see what are the actual outside diameters of pipe. NPS 1 inches has actual OD of 1.5 by 16 inches, that is 33.4 mm. NPS 2 has an actual OD of 2.3 by 8 inches, that is 60.3 mm. NPS 4 has an actual OD of 4.5 inches, that is 114.3 mm. NPS 14 has an actual OD of 14 inches, that is 355.6 mm. From 14 just onwards, OD matches with the NPS size. Now let us see the actual inside diameters of a 2 inch pipe. For different schedules, there is different thickness, which gives us different IDs of a 2 inch pipe. Let's see how. For example, for schedule 10, the pipe thickness in mm is 2.77 mm. Which gives us an ID of 54.76 mm for an OD of 60.3 mm. For schedule standard, thickness of pipe is 3.91 mm, which gives us an ID of 52.48 mm with an OD of 60.3 mm, which is fixed. For schedule 160, the thickness of pipe is 8.74 mm, which gives us an ID of 42.82 mm with OD 60.3 mm. The standard combination of pipes, nominal pipe size and wall thickness, that is schedule, are covered by the ASME B36.10 and ASME B36.19 specifications, respectively carbon and alloy pipes and stainless steel pipes. In case of tube, actual OD is same as OD mentioned, like 1 inch tube has an actual OD of 1 inches only. 4 inch tube has an actual OD of 4 inches. You can see these tables for 2 inch tube showing variation in inside diameter according to gauge variation, where OD is 50.8 mm constant. This table shows the variation based on Birmingham wire gauge. For example, Birmingham wire gauge of 7, the thickness of a tube is 4.57 mm, which gives us an ID of 41.6 mm. For BW gauge of 12, thickness of tube is 2.768 mm, which gives us an ID of 45.264 mm.
For BW gauge of 24, the thickness of 0.56 is there, which gives us an ID of 49.68 mm. Now let's look at the second table, which shows the variation based on standard wire gauge. Let's see how. For standard wire gauge of 7, The thickness of tube is 4.47 mm, which gives us an ID of 41.86 mm. Similarly, for SW gauge of 22, thickness is 0.711, which gives us an ID of 49.378. Now, if you see closely or compare two tables, you'll notice that after the gauge value of 22 for both BW gauge and SW gauge, ID of pipe becomes same in both the cases. In other terms, if you'll notice, after 22 gauge in both the tables, dimensions start to match. These table dimensions are based on seamless tubes according to standard ASTM A450/A450M. So, to determine ID of pipe or tube, one should subtract 2 times of thickness from OD. So, after this basic difference of shape, ID or OD and thickness, we will see some more differences like material.
For a pipe, a wide range of materials is available like carbon steel, stainless steel, alloy steel, etc. For tubes, the material available is carbon steel, low alloy, stainless steel, copper, aluminium, nickel alloys, PVC and inconel. Now, let's discuss about end connections and joining process. For pipe, the most common end connections are beveled, plain and screwed end. Welding, threading and flange connections are very common. Whereas for tube, threaded and grooved ends are available for quicker connections on site with flaring, brazing and coupling as a joining process. Now we will talk about size. Pipes is available in a wide range from 1 by 8 inches, that is 0.25 inches to 80 inches. Whereas tubes are available in a small range from 1 by 4 inches to 5.5 inches. What about tolerance? Pipe wall thickness have plus minus 12.5% mill tolerance. Hence, actual ID of a given pipe may differ from theoretical value. Whereas, in case of tubes, steel tubes are produced to very strict tolerances, undergo several dimension quality checks such as straightness, roundness, wall thickness, surface, etc. during the manufacturing process. Now, let's have a look at the application. Pipes are used to transport fluids like liquids and gases, majorly used for pressurized services and high temperature services. For tubes, as far as oil and gas industry is concerned, it is used as instrument tubing like for pneumatic services. It is used in exchanger, boiler and cooler tubes. It is also used as structure member for bracing. What about strength? Pipe strength is not the major concern, but threaded end pipe has lesser strength, whereas for same size, tubes are stronger. In terms of cost, pipes have relatively lower price per ton than steel tubes, since they are manufactured on stock and quality checking procedure is less. On the other hand, tubes have higher prices due to lower mill productivity per hour and due to the stricter requirements in terms of tolerances and inspections. In terms of production process, pipe mills produce on a continuous basis and feed distributors stock around the world, whereas tubes manufacturing is more lengthy and laborious. From surface finish point of view, pipes are painted or coated for anti-corrosion and oxidation except SS pipes, whereas tubes undergo special polishing treatments like mill, bright anneal, etc. While ordering, pipes ordering description is NPS cross schedule, whereas for tubes, ordering description is either OD into ID or ID into thickness. From the point of view of delivery time, usually pipe takes shorter time to deliver as compared to tubes. For packing, now for in case of pipes, we just want to protect the pipe surface from any serious damage, so we do not pack it in. Whereas tubes are usually packed in wooden boxes or thin film. Now, let's see the difference on bendable front. Pipes are less bendable. More standard fitting is required as compared to tubes, which are more bendable. Tubes can be bent to desired degree with less number of fittings required. So, that is it guys for today's video. Soon, we will come back with another interesting topic. So, stay tuned. If you have any queries or doubts, please write to us in comment section below. Also, please like, share and subscribe. Till next time, bye-bye. Take care.